you consider that if a patient comes to you, if they have all the other problems are solved, if you they just want to go for the IVF, then what is the time frame actually?
Okay.
How long they have to stay over there? In case of Indian, they don't have any problem. But in case of other people who comes from abroad or outside of India, how many time they should take for a this procedure?
Okay. So most of our couples, they plan the visit prior. So before coming, they email us or they call us, they get all the dates. So what we do is we give them specific dates to come. So mostly it is 1 day before periods, or at least second day or third day of periods. So when they come on second day of periods, the evaluation is done on the same day, and next day we have all the reports in hand. The treatment starts on the next day, and in next 15 days the entire treatment will be completed. So 10 days is for giving injections, 8 to 9, 10 days for injections. Then 11th day, egg pickup will be done, the eggs will be taken out, and the embryos will be produced in 3 to 4 days. Once the embryos are formed, the embryo transfer will be done on the 5th day. That is 10 days after putting injection, 15th day the embryo transfer will be done. So altogether the treatment takes 15 to maximum 17 days, and the couple can take rest for 1 day, 2 day, and they can go back. So we need minimum of 18 to 20 days to finish the complete IVF treatment.
So minimum 1 month, more or less 1 month is needed for the IVF. If you found money another problems associated with the IVF before doing the IVF, how you suggest the patient that you ask them to stay, or you ask them to go to have these medications, or life change the lifestyle like this, then you ask them to come back again?
Okay. In IVF, importantly, you have to consider two things. One is, first important thing is whether you have PCOD, that is irregular cycle. In irregular cycle, what happens is that when you put injection, too many follicle grows, too many eggs you get. So there is a chance of hyperstimulation. In those cases, what we do is we freeze the embryos. We create embryo, freeze the embryo, ask the couple to go back and come after 1 month, 2 month or 3 month. And next visit, they have to stay for only 1 week, finish the embryo transfer and go back. This is one indication. The next important thing is many couples come with severe endometriosis, adenomyosis, bulky uterus, all these problems. What we do is that we collect eggs, create embryo, freeze. Mm-hmm. They have to go back and come after 3 months or 6 months, depending on the situation, how the uterus size is. So they have to take monthly injection for 6 months or 3 months, and then they have to come for embryo transfer for 1 week. So it's a two-step process for women with PCOS and chocolate cyst. These are the two conditions. It's a two-step process.
Okay. We'll discuss about the issue again. We have a phone call. We are taking this. Hello, Darshak. Your name is Prashuti Korun.
Yes, my name is Hasina Jalak.
I am going to conceive for 3 years.
জি আমি ডাক্তার দেখিয়েছি, আমি ডাক্তার ওষুধ কন্টিনিউ করেছি।
উনি কি কোন ধরনের সমস্যার কথা বলেছে যে আমার আপনার এই ধরনের সমস্যা আছে যার কারণে আপনার দেরি
হচ্ছে? না না, আমার এই ধরনের কোনো সমস্যা নাই, কিন্তু আমি একটা কনসেপ করেছিলাম, আমার বেবিটা পড়ে গিয়েছে।
এটা বিয়ের কত বছরে?
জি 3 বছর।
মানে কোন বছরে এটা হয়েছিল?
এটা আমার গত বছর হয়েছিল, 1 বছর আগে।
1 বছর আগে। আপনার হাজবেন্ডের সব রিপোর্ট ওকে আছে?
জি আমার হাজবেন্ডের রিপোর্ট ওকে আছে।
আচ্ছা, সেটা হওয়ার পরে আপনি আবারও চেষ্টা করছেন কিন্তু হচ্ছে না?
জি হচ্ছে না।
সেটা ডাক্তার কাছে যখন গেছিলেন উনি কিছু বলেননি যে কেন হচ্ছে না বা চেষ্টা
করেন? উনি বলছে যে হবে, কিন্তু উনি ওষুধ দিয়েছে, আমি ওষুধ খাচ্ছি, বাট আমি এখনো কনসেপ্ট করতে পারছি না।
ওকে। The patient on the phone is saying that she is married for 3 years. She conceived in the second years of her marriage, but the baby, she miscarried the baby, but now she's trying, but she's not getting pregnant. So what should be the suggestion for her?
Okay, definitely the next step is to evaluate the tubes. Generally, whenever a miscarriage happens, there's a very high chance of tubes getting infected or blocked. Okay. So definitely we have to evaluate the tubes. So since you're married for only 3 years, you can do a HSG, hysterosalpingogram. It's a simple x-ray. It's a 10-minute procedure. It will give you whether the tubes are open or not. After checking the tubes, then you can start further treatment.
আমাদের সাথে যিনি ডক্টর রয়েছেন উনি সাজেস্ট করছেন যে যাদের একবার বাচ্চা মিসক্যারেজ হয় বা এই ধরনের সমস্যা হয় তাদের টিউব ব্লক হওয়ার বা ইনফেক্টেড হওয়ার একটা চান্স থাকে। তো সেই টিউবগুলো ব্লক হয়ে গিয়েছে কিনা বা ইনফেকশন আছে কিনা সেটা দেখার জন্য ল্যাপারোস্কোপি অথবা হিস্টেরোসালপিংগোগ্রাম যদি করা হয় তাহলে টিউবগুলো ওপেন আছে কিনা সেটা দেখা যাবে, যেই টিউব দিয়ে ডিমগুলো আসবে আর কি। সেই সেটা যদি ওপেন না থাকে তাহলে বাচ্চা আপনি ট্রাই করলেও হবে না। সেই বিষয়টি ডাক্তারের কাছে যেয়ে যদি আপনি একবার বলেন তাহলে এই ধরনের টেস্ট করে আপনি জানতে পারবেন যে আপনার টিউবগুলো ঠিক আছে কিনা। যদি টিউব ঠিক থাকে তাহলে ডাক্তারের পরামর্শ অনুযায়ী আপনি চেষ্টা করতে থাকুন, আশা করি আপনি কনসিভ করতে পারবেন। দর্শক অনেক ধন্যবাদ আমাদের প্রশ্নটি করার জন্য। We are just discussing about the choclosis and PCOS have different indications for IVF. There are some people who have semen analysis problem with the male. If the infertility is in case of in male, then what is the process of IVF?
If the male has sperm problem, say sperm count is low or the motility is low, morphology is low, or say there are no sperms, definitely the step is ICSI, ICSI, intracytoplasmic sperm injection. In IVF, what we do is we take sperms, we collect the eggs, put it in dish, fertilization happens naturally. Whereas with low sperm count and low motility, what we have to do is ICSI. So we take eggs, we clean the eggs, we take individual sperm, select the best sperm and inject directly into the egg. So this is called ICSI. We do this process. This is for definitely, it's a good thing for male factor infertility.
Male factor involved, okay.
So this is the main thing.
Main thing, okay. Any type of life history modification you ask for during the time of IVF or anything?
Generally, lifestyle modification is not required during the process of IVF. It's a very short process, 10 days. So, it's not logical to do any lifestyle modification in those 10 days. Already, it's a very stressful days. 10 days is a very stressful period. So, you can't do any lifestyle modification in those 10 days.
During the process of IVF, you give the sperm to the ovum. You just select one ovum or more than one to fertilize them properly, because only one ovum will not get the proper size sometimes. So, you go for the multiple like this you do there.
Yeah. Generally, there are two types of IVF. One is natural cycle IVF. In natural cycle IVF, you get one follicle, one egg. And stimulator cycle. Stimulator cycle, we are using injections, so you get too many follicle and many eggs. So definitely, doing stimulation is better, because in natural cycle, one egg, we are not sure whether the egg is going to be fine, whether one embryo is going to be there, whether the embryo will be fine, we are not sure. Whereas in stimulated IVF, we get many
but
eggs.
When is the condition?
Okay, natural cycle IVF, when we do is that when a couple is elderly, more than 40 years, there are no eggs available. So if there are only few eggs available, ovarian reserve, there is no point putting injection. There are no eggs inside. So don't put any injection, do natural cycle IVF. Collect that one egg, two egg and do IVF.
Okay,
that is
okay.
The thing.
But the hyperstimulation of IVF, if in case of more than one ovum is matured or fertilized, then what you do? You place the more than one or something, or like this one?
Okay. Generally, actually what is advisable is definitely single embryo transfer, because if you transfer two or three embryos, there is a high chance of having twins. But the important thing you should consider is that in US and Europe, the government sponsors this infertility treatment. It is free. So they do single embryo for many times. But in country like India, Bangladesh, patients pay their own money.
Yeah.
So you can't transfer single embryo. The result is definitely not as good as transferring two or three embryos. So definitely you have to transfer two or three embryos.
Okay.
If the patient is affordable, they can spend money, they are fine, then transfer single embryo. But in our developing countries, finance is a big issue.
Take the chance of having one embryo over there and losing that the chance.
Correct.
Okay, we are getting the point again. There is a phone call. We are taking this. হ্যালো দর্শক, আপনার নাম বলে প্রশ্নটি করুন।
আমি সুদীপ বিশ্বাস বলছি।
জি।
আমার কোশ্চেনটা হচ্ছিল, আমাদের বিয়ে 3 বছর হয়েছে, তো আমরা 3 বছরের ভিতরে কনসিভ করিনি, ট্রাই করিনি, তো আমরা প্ল্যান করছি কনসিভ করব, কিন্তু সমস্যাটা হচ্ছিল আমার ওয়াইফের এজ হচ্ছিল 40 প্লাস, 41, নিয়ারলি 41, এবং হেলদি চেহারা। তা এতে কি কোনো সমস্যা আছে? কনসিভ করলে পরে কোনো সমস্যা পড়তে পারি কিনা?
Okay, দর্শক আপনি লাইন থাকুন, আমরা উত্তরটি নিচ্ছি। দ্য পারসন হু ইজ হু কলড, হি অ্যাকচুয়ালি দে আর ম্যারিড ফর 3 ইয়ার্স, বাট দে ডিডন্ট ইভেন ট্রাই ফর দ্য কনসিভিং, বাট দে ওয়ান্ট টু ট্রাই ফর দ্য কনসিভ টু কনসিভ, বাট দ্য এজেস অফ দ্য ওয়াইফ ইজ 41, সো অ্যান্ড শি ইজ হেলদি অলসো, সো ইফ দে আর এনি সাজেশন বিফোর ট্রাইং অর সামথিং।
ওকে, the most critical point is the age. Generally, more than 40 years, the egg count is very, very low already. If you wait further, the egg count will go down and your cycles may become irregular also. So time is, you should not lose any time. Directly, you can try naturally for one or two cycles, then immediately go for IUA one or two cycle. If it is not working out, you have to jump into IVF. You don't have any other choice, because the age is 40. Already, there are only few eggs. So you shouldn't lose those eggs. That's very important.
Okay. দর্শক আমাদের ডক্টরের সাজেশন হচ্ছেন অলরেডি আপনারা একটা হাই রিস্কের দিকে আছেন, কারণ যতই বয়স বাড়বে ততই ওভাম বা মানে এগ যে বা ডিমটা তৈরি হওয়ার ক্ষমতাটা কমে যায় মহিলাদের। সো আপনি যেই এজে আছেন তাতে করে অলরেডি তার এটা কমে গেছে, আরও যদি অপেক্ষা করেন তাহলে আরও কমে যাবে। সুতরাং সেক্ষেত্রে উচিত হবে এখন থেকেই চেষ্টা করা আপনার বাচ্চা নেওয়ার জন্য, সেক্ষেত্রে কোনো অসুবিধা হবে না। দর্শক অনেক ধন্যবাদ আমাদের প্রশ্নটি করার জন্য। So you are discussing about the things that actually this is a very important point, because we discuss about so many about doctors that we never discuss that how many eggs we actually give to the patient or something. So now we want to know the outcomes of the IVF in case of your center, as you are working in a renowned fertility center. In case of your center, what is the outcome? Actually, it is how many people you are treating, how many patients or couples you are treating, and how many successful rates are over there?
Okay. Our center has been doing this exclusive infertility practice for more than 20 years. So it's one of the oldest centers in India. So what we see is that earlier when we started, the success rate was only 30% in IVF. Slowly it increased, and now we are having a success rate of 70 to 80% every month consistently. And why this fluctuation, 70, 80, is purely dependent on the age of the patients. Some month when we get a lot of young patients, the result will be 90%. Sometime we get a lot of 45 years, 50 years, 48 years. Then the success rate will be 60 to 70%. So the success rate keeps fluctuating, but bare minimum is 60 to 70.
According to the age count, actually, the success rate. If we are treating a younger patient, the data is something different. If you are treating an older patient, that is something different. Exactly. We can compare the data, actually. Because sometimes we say, like as a whole, I went there, but it was failed. But we have to consider the age also. Because the patient was 25, but the patient was 35 is not the same thing happens. So I just want to ask you about the cost, that I just want to know, because as the patients are watching and the audiences are watching, that if they have the intention to do something over there in Chennai, in your fertility center, Aishwarya. So what is the cost actually? Like if you say the range actually, because all the costs are not the same, the tests and other things are different. And if they have to come again, then the cost is different. So what is the range actually? How much it takes in INR?
If you use the best injection, say the Pentape, Gunalef pens, Pentape injection is the most expensive one, fully imported from Germany. If you use that and do IVF, the cost of doing IVF is 1.8 lakhs. IVF, ICSI, full transfer. Apart from this, you have to spend for...
2 lakhs.
Apart from that, you have to spend for blood test, scan, consultation, hysteroscopy. So you have to be prepared for another 50,000. So you have to be prepared for 2.3 to maximum 2.5 lakhs. So this will be the budget for freezing everything altogether.
So means you are saying that all the things, if you consider, if complex or more than complex things, it will take 2.5 to more near about 3 lakhs. Not more than that.
Not more than 2.5. Treatment will be 2.5. Then flight tickets and food, travel accommodation may cost more.
But the treatment cost will be like 2.5 lakh, the maximum.
Correct.
Okay, so 2.5 lakh in Bangladeshi taka is near to 3 lakhs like this. Okay, Sathya. So, in case of your center, is there any facilities of having any free cost treatments, or if you do any kind of any specific days or in some things, free treatments or something?
We don't have as such any free treatment, because the medicines are very expensive.
Okay.
Consultation and some evaluation, we do it free for poor couples.
Mm-hmm.
But generally, people from Bangladesh, they are already prepared for IVF, they come directly for IVF. Local, it is different. We do a lot of free evaluation. In Bangladesh, I don't think flight tickets are very expensive, all these things. So, it may not be very much possible. Actually.
Okay. So, you are doing in fertility center. So if you recruit more and more doctors over there, they got only the infertility treatment. You don't go for any gynecological practices over there.
Yeah, because we have to focus on one treatment. Only then you can do it properly. If you do everything, pregnancy, delivery, this, that, you won't be able to focus. You have to focus on one thing, only then you'll be able to master.
So
if you do everything.
So in your center, only IVF is done over there,
yeah,
or other
infertility.
Evaluation of infertility.
Yeah.
Not pregnancy or delivery or anything.
No.
Okay, so we are near to finish the show. It is like 2 minutes left over there. So if you want to say something to the audiences, you can say.
Okay, the main important thing I observed with so many days of Bangladeshi patients is that people who have endometriosis, they are actually waiting too long. When they wait too long, you don't have any eggs, and there is a high chance of going for donor eggs. So my humble request is that whenever you have endometriosis, try to do IVF as early as possible. Even if it is financially tough, somehow manage and do IVF. Otherwise, you are going to lose the chance later. And if you have PCOS, please be patient, don't be impatient. And I know you have to do a lot of education studies, but give priority to pregnancy first. So don't delay the marriage and career.
Arun, it was our immense pleasure to have you in our show, and so many thanks to come to our show in this bad weather also.
Thank you. Very okay. Nice having you.
Okay. সুপ্রিয় দর্শক, স্বাস্থ্য কথা অনুষ্ঠানটিতে আমাদের আজকের বিষয় ছিল ইনফার্টিলি অ্যান্ড ইটস ট্রিটমেন্ট। এই বিষয়টি নিয়ে আমাদের আজকে বিশেষজ্ঞের কাছ থেকে আপনারা অনেক কিছু জানতে পারলেন। আশা করি দর্শক আপনারা উপকৃত হয়েছেন। স্বাস্থ্য কথা অনুষ্ঠানটি আজকের মতো এখানে শেষ করতে হচ্ছে। আবার দেখা হবে আগামী পর্বে ঠিক একই সময়ে। ততদিন পর্যন্ত অপেক্ষা থাকুন, সুস্থ থাকুন এবং অবশ্যই ভালো থাকুন।